What is going on, guys? Hess here. I want to bring you guys this video, just kind of a random vlog video, me shopping around Portland. Basically, we have house cleaners at the house right now, and Harrison is at the in-laws and the wife is at work, so I have the day to myself. I have no idea what to do, so I decided I might as well go to Portland because they're doing some like crazy cleaning in the house today, so I'm gonna go ahead and just try to find some things out here. Thrift store was a bust. They really didn't have anything at Goodwill, so I'm gonna keep it rolling and I'm going to go to Nike Portland, check that out, hopefully go to Bait, and just continue just randomly shopping around Portland today.
You will arrive at 10:20 a.m.
Man, check this out. Walking to Nike Portland and I see this guy right here. This would be dope to own. Pretty good shape too, look at this. All right, so I'm in Nike store Portland and check out this waffle wall, dude. I had no idea that the whole background was actually waffles, and you can see the background, just not look at the shoes. Just look at the background and then check this out over here on the side. It tells you why, so you can screenshot that if you guys want and see why, but I thought that was pretty cool. And then upstairs they had the Time to Shine pack, and this was actually my first look at the KD9 Elite. Pretty cool display that these sneakers are on though, but here is a close-up of the LeBron 14 in the white colorway. This honestly reminds me of like a Christmas colorway or just a winter colorway, so timing is maybe a little bit odd, or maybe it's not, maybe it's a spring colorway. But check out the back though, it's woven. I didn't realize that, kind of cool. And then here is a look at the KD9, and this is the elite version, and it is $150, which is the same price as the regular one. Honestly, really weird collar. I can't really explain the collar. It's so loose looking. It's like they just added that on. The sole and the midsole look exactly the same as the other one, but I have a comparison in this video that I'll show you guys. So hopefully you guys will find that informative for those wondering and wanted to see that. But check out the flywire replaced by like shoestrings. I don't really know. Like, it's kind of weird that they did that. It's an interesting looking like weave sort of pattern because of it. But here's that side-by-side that I was talking about. I just wanted to show you guys the difference, and I had a look at the soles and see, I was like, well, are they exactly the same or what's going on? And I'm sure most of you guys already knew this if you guys are like really interested in the KD, but for me, like, I've heard the Elite is coming out, I wanted to see it, and that is that. But this is the coolest upgrade though, is the pattern for the Flyknit looks a lot softer and it looks a lot better on the Elite version. Also, the placement of the Nike swoosh is a little bit different, and it looks a little bit better on the newer version as well. Interestingly enough, like, Nike ended up just dropping the Elite prices down to the same price as the release pair, which is just really crazy. Usually it's like such a huge premium. I bet those would have been $225. Not sure what made them change their mind. Check out the back though, a little bit different as well, and the collar height is bigger obviously. Also, but that flimsy look to them, I'm not really sure how I feel about it. I don't know if it's one that you can wear casually like the regular version. It just doesn't seem like a casual looking shoe because of that weird collar. But price point again, exactly the same. Upper looks like it has a nice improvement to it, but that collar, I'd probably just want to cut off or have it sewed differently or something. But But yeah, that's kind of a side-by-side for those wanting to see them. What do you guys think about the new KD9 Elite? Leave a comment. Let me know. I'm curious to see what you guys say. I'm also interested to see if they make a LeBron 14 Elite and what the price point will be on that. Check out the bottom of the Kyrie 3, though, in this white and silver colorway. Kind of cool. Kyrie 3 seems to be a pretty good model. I definitely want to ID my pair whenever that happens. Check this out, though. This is a look at the Kobe AD NXT, and this is a really interesting looking model. I cannot believe the price point, $200. I like that they have the drop-in midsole again, but I don't really know about this cover shroud thing over the laces and the new lacing system. I don't think that those are going to hold down your shoe when you're actually hooping in them. And I thought this was going to be geared towards the lifestyle side of things, but it's actually a performance shoe, which I think is a mistake in itself. So they should have definitely reinvented this in a lifestyle model and made that cover elastic in a sense. But it is what it is. I wanted to see them in person. To me, this one's kind of a flop. I don't know. I like the Kobe line a lot, and I had some expectations that this one could have been cool, but I don't think it was going to be it. These ones, on the other hand, were actually kind of interesting. It looks just like a regular shoe, but look at the sole. You could definitely feel a zoom in those new revs. And then just kind of a look at some of the sneakers around in the store. And then these things, I think, are probably the biggest sleeper that's out there for a like an all-terrain shoe. And I really like this Flyknit version, but $225 was a lot, and they're on sale for like $170-something, as you can see right there. But clean colorway, nonetheless. And here we have the Jordans, and sitting, and sitting, and sitting, and sitting. And then these are sitting as well. Honestly, I expected these to be sitting, and it's one of those ones that I was definitely anticipating for this year, but I knew that it was just going to be a massive general release, so it was just going to be one that was not felt by the masses, even though the original Motorsport one from back in the day was like super grail status. One that is also sitting is the 12 Lows. I think that could be a good summer shoe though, and I really like this colorway. But that's kind of it for the Nike Portland, so I'll go ahead and get on with my vlog. Sorry about the dub over, but the music was too loud.
All right, so Nike Portland was pretty fun. I saw a couple models that I've been wanting to see in person. The Kobe one that has the laces that are all weird, and price point $200 though, I don't know if those are gonna sell. I just feel like that price point is too high, and they probably should have taken that approach for a casual shoe instead of a actual performance shoe. It just makes no sense. But the one I was most impressed by was the KD9. The fact that it's 150, that's a steal for the Elite version. And yeah. Same price as a regular one, but Nike Portland is fun. I'm going to go to Buffalo Exchange now and check out what they have in the thrift at Buffalo.
All right, one of my favorite stores to go thrifting at is Buffalo Exchange off of Burnside in Portland, and they always usually have some pretty good deals there, and I end up always running into a couple samples as well, so it's always fun to see. Decent prices usually as well, under $50. Speaking of decent prices though, $30 for these KD6s. Somebody leave a comment, let me know what colorway this is in the comment section. You guys will remember. I cannot remember for the life of me. I thought it was Aunt Pearl at first, and then I think it's like the Meteor or something. I don't even know. But look at these crazy, like, I don't even know what these are, like crap kickers. I don't know. It has this huge metal plate sort of thing. Those things were serious. And then this was really cool. It says about the detail property of Nike, but those were not actually samples, which I thought that was really, really odd. I thought it was actually a sample, but pretty cool if they actually released those and they had that little nod to the sample life. Pythons there, and then some Adidas joints right here, EQT, and some Boost, $30, but these ones were beat up a little bit. From the bottom, you can tell, but from the side you couldn't. And then some Kobe's and some Lillard's for $40. Those ones were pretty much brand new. And these ones are brand new as well. You can see not even tried on for $40. And interesting looking Nikes with kind of that worn look. This one, I was like, wait a minute. No way. Are these fake? I don't know. I don't remember these low top versions. And the stitching around the side looked really questionable. But I don't think that they made fake versions of these 23 lows. But the patent looked a little bit off on them, but crazy that they had those there. I don't usually see a lot of those. There's another one of those Nikes there and some more Kobe's, it looks like. Some Air Max 90s, always have usually like one pair of those or an Air Max 1. And then the Jordan 9 inspired colorway of those weird, I think those are the Flight 45s or something. And then some old school joints right here. I can't, those are the Pippins, I believe. And then some boot 90s. And they always have really fun stuff at this store, though. And this time the staff was like super friendly. Everybody was talking to me. In fact, they were asking me about what I was filming and stuff. And I told them about my sneaker stuff. This is actually a sample. I was curious about it. It's a woman's shoe. And then I looked and I was like, oh, yeah, it is a sample. So kind of a fun one. I think that they actually have these in Boost now in women's. That's like an EQT sort of sneaker. $35, size 8 women's. And weird because samples usually are size 7. But I don't know, just pointing that out. Air Force One flying it and $48 for 6.5. My coworker was actually looking for that one, which is funny that they had exactly her size and color that she wanted. And some interesting ones as well. It's kind of weird colors of those. And the Pure Boost X for the women's for $28.50. That's a steal. That would have been a good price for those as well. But the staff member actually pulled these out. She said, you want to see some? I think they're fake. And you can check them out if you would like. So we were looking at the tags. And obviously I was like, these, yeah, they're super fake. It's like the Yeezy, it's the Yeezy Roshis that we've seen. And the soles definitely felt really weird. I've never held them in person or anything. But I remember seeing these on the internet. And I was like, oh yeah, this is hilarious. But they were going to sell them for like $40. But definitely cool. It's cool that they legit check there a little bit and make sure that they are selling authentic products. And then these ones are really weird samples that I saw. It looks like some like dance shoes or something like that. I'm not really sure what they're for, but pretty cool Nike samples. So no super heat this time, but it was fun browsing around, seeing random samples. And yeah, let's continue on.
All right, so that was pretty fun, just thrifting around, looking at Buffalo Exchange. Last stop, I'm gonna try to go to Bait, see if they're open. And then maybe some Blue Star Donuts. I mean, why not?
Walking around Portland. That place right there is where I got this ring from the wife. Pretty awesome. All right, last shopping stop, Bait in Portland. And this is off of Broadway. And check it out. I like the X's on the open sign. And these RT 97s, I think, or 98s, these were pretty cool to see in person. They have a little tongue spot that has a zipper that has like a little hidden pouch that I thought was kind of cool that I didn't realize that was there. These are the like new colorway of the up tempos, and I'm not really a big fan of that colorway. Ran into some buddies, Jailblazing, rocking some heat, and Cole as well. Got a lot of Jordan retro sitting as you can see here. And then what do we have here? Bear Bricks. I always love that this store has a mix of toys and sneakers and clothes and pop culture, all things I definitely like to see. And speaking of, check these out. Those Street Fighter socks are sick. I have so many Street Fighter tees still. It's pretty crazy. I was hoping to find some new ones. I didn't see any. Lots of Adidas in stock, including these Trail Boosts. And these are an interesting one. Look at the traction on them. I wonder if you could even feel the boost with that much traction, though. And then check this out. Yeezy, Yeezy, Yeezy. This is hilarious. Nah, you know, I wonder how many people actually bought these instead of the Yeezys because they look so similar. But $85, it's like, why not? I don't even know what collaboration these ones were, but these Reeboks look pretty cool. Definitely like the overall look of those. And then, surprise, surprise, I can't believe they had these Kip joints in stock here. 200 plus, though, for the collab is definitely a little bit high, in my opinion, but cool to see them in stock. And then for the ladies, surprised that they have so many more of these Pumas that are coming out. They were kind of limited at first, and then now they seem to just have massive GRs. This was probably one of the coolest sneakers I saw there. I didn't know that they made this colorway in the Toy Story a collab for Vans. I really thought this one was done really well. Some Astro Boy Bates apparel, and then random Back to the Future stuff. And then Supersized, some Star Wars paraphernalia as well. And just kind of just browsing through the rest of the store, as you can see here. Some more bricks and some more bricks. That one on the left is crazy. And then I was just kind of sifting through the clothes, trying to find like some tees or something. They usually have some pretty cool brands here as well as their own brand. I like that hoodie as an example right there. But they have some BBC and some Stussy and Undefeated. I usually like the Undefeated stuff, so I gravitate towards that or some of the pop culture tees. But I didn't see anything this time that I really wanted, so I didn't end up buying anything. But BBC isn't really something that I've bought before. I like that shirt actually quite a bit, but not in that yellow. If it was just in black or white, I would have liked it better. So it kind of has that 8-bit Nintendo sort of look to it. And some staple stuff. I need to get some more staple apparel. I actually really like the staple line as well. I just haven't bought a lot of it. And some undefeated bomber jacket here. I have some undefeated pickups actually pretty soon that you guys will probably see in an unboxing. Cocaine is different than steroids. Surrender, and then that undefeated embroidered logo tee was actually pretty cool. But I ended up passing on it. Decided I didn't need it.
So bait was pretty cool. Chopped it up with some buddies and basically just looked around the store. It's crazy that they had those naked joints in. I guess they've had those in stock the whole time. So I need to go and check it bait more often because they seem to get a lot of the random stuff that the big shops don't get. So I was hoping for another undefeated hat or some bait tees, but I didn't see any new ones. So I held off. But I wanted that little bear brick, the little Elmo type one, but I held off too. 150 bucks, a kid won't really even like it, but he loves Elmo, so I thought it'd been funny.
So final stop before I went home, I went to Blue Star Donuts, and it was kind of like one of those must stop things. When I have freedom for a day, I'm like, this is definitely my go-to. Blue Star has like some of the most crazy unique flavors for donuts. In fact, if you guys can read any of them on here, leave a comment, let me know like which two you would have copped, because there's so many good flavors. I've had most of them. I ended up getting a couple random ones. The passion fruit was one of them, and the chocolate as well. But that's pretty much it. Blue Star, success.
Grassa. So this is what I ended up getting from Grassa. Ooh. This is like handmade pasta. It's amazing. The garlic bread's amazing. Spaghetti for the wife. Some meatballs. But this stuff is so good, dude. And it's like, if you like truffle, man, it's delicious. Delicious. Anyways, that's pretty much it. Got the lunch, and the house is looking pretty clean over here. If you can see, the couch is all clean. Dogs are chilling. And I'm gonna eat lunch and just kind of enjoy the rest of my day. And hopefully you guys like the video. Just kind of random. Hopefully it was a little bit more engaging than my last one that had no music. And the last one that I just dubbed over only voice. So yeah, appreciate y'all. Peace.